Hi there, and welcome to the second recording of this video, because the first time I forgot to record the audio. But it's okay, I'm still smiling. See? I'm smiling. No, anyway. So I got a comment on one of my previous videos asking me what my film grain settings are in DaVinci Resolve, because quote unquote, it looks so clean. And it was this video, by the way. We were on holiday in Greece a few weeks ago and I made this travel sequence. I'll put a link to the full video in the description. But yeah, I instantly smiled when I saw that comment, because this was actually the first time that I myself was satisfied with how my film grain looked. Because it's so difficult to get it right. And there's actually one super important setting that has nothing to do with the film grain itself, but it immensely affects how your film grain will look in the end. Does that make sense even? If it doesn't right now, it will in a bit, for sure. Now, before I show you how I did it and my settings, there's a few important things you should know. First of all, it's all a very subjective matter, you know? Some people like a lot of film grain and some people prefer a minimal amount, so always keep that in mind. But an even bigger problem with adding film grain is YouTube. Yeah, YouTube compression and film grain, they don't like each other. So in the past, a lot of times I was using settings that looked good in DaVinci Resolve, but then when I uploaded the video to YouTube, it turned into a messy blob of artifacts. You all know what it looks like, right? And also the resolution that the viewer chooses when watching your video is important. If they set it too low, the grain is gone. A lot of you who watched my travel sequence probably didn't even see the grain because you were watching it in 720p on a smartphone, for example. But that's fine, of course. It's YouTube's fault. And then finally, also screen size matters. If you watch a video that has film grain on a small screen and the film grain is very fine, small, it might not be visible at all. And I know that some content creators increase the size of the film grain so that it's still visible on small screens and at lower resolutions like 1080 and 720. But then when you watch those videos on a big screen, there might be too much grain. So all I want to say here is that the difficult part is to find a balance between all those things. And it's impossible to give you settings that will look good no matter what. Oh yeah, right, before I forget, did you see that video transition? I also used it in my travel sequence, and I made it with the help of Storyblocks, the sponsor of this video. It looks super cool, but it's also super simple. I went to Storyblocks, typed in vintage projector overlay, picked one that I like, and just dropped it on my timeline. Now, of course, it also needed sound effects. But also for sound effects, Storyblocks has you covered. Add them to the transition and boom, you're done. I mean, it doesn't get any simpler than that, right? And they also have stock footage, templates, animated backgrounds, basically everything a creative needs. Everything's royalty free, so you can use Storyblocks assets for social media, but also for client work. And with a subscription, you get unlimited downloads. So you'll save time and money. Go check out Storyblocks by using my link storyblocks.com/Joris Hermans in the description. Okay, and now back to film grain. Here are the settings that I used for that travel sequence. So I edit my videos in 4K, and so I want my film grain to look good in 4K, obviously, but also in 1080. Even though, of course, I know that, I mean, you always lose some of the grain, some of the crispiness because of YouTube compression. But anyway, let's add a film grain node, and it has to be the last node. That's important. And then the first thing I do is use this preset, 35mm 400T. But the problem with this preset is that the grain looks too fine, too small. It looks okay in 4K, but it would just disappear in 1080 after uploading it to YouTube. So we need to tweak the settings a little bit now. And obviously the first thing you should do is increase the grain size. I went all the way up to 0.6. Now that's pretty big, but remember we're dealing with compression, different resolutions, different screen sizes. Now increasing the size makes the grain look softer, and the softer it looks, the more YouTube compression will destroy. So what I also did is lower the softness to around 0.2. It makes the film grain a bit crisper and, well yeah, sharper. And then the only settings that I sometimes also play around with is the opacity. Depending on the brightness and the overall look of your color grade, this might bring out the film grain a little bit better. See what it does? But those are the only settings in film grain that I adjust. But like I said in the beginning of the video, there's one setting that's maybe even more important than the film grain settings. Because look, we're adding film grain. So obviously we're trying to make our footage look and feel like film, right? So what we have to do is get rid of that digital look. And there's a few ways to do that. Color grading is one way. I'll make a video on how I color graded that sequence in a few weeks, and then you'll see all the effects and techniques that I used. But there's another thing you should do, and that's reduce the sharpness. Because if you add film grain to footage that looks super crisp and super sharp, digitally sharp, it just doesn't look right. It doesn't feel right. So that was the moment when I thought, oh, that's how you can make film grain look good. And it's simple, really. All you have to do is add a node before the film grain node, and this is important because if you do the blurring in the film grain node, then you'll ruin the grain. So add a node before and then go to the blur tab here and increase the radius to add some blur and reduce the detail a little bit. Get rid of that digital sharpness. Not too much, of course. I mean, you don't want it to look blurry, just enough. It also depends on your camera, the lens, the resolution. Just play around with it a little bit. And that's basically it. That's how I did the film grain for that travel sequence. Now, as always, these are my settings. I mean, I like these settings. If you like them too, of course, feel free to use them. These settings are not my property, of course. But if you don't like them, just play around with the other settings. Maybe there's a combination that you like better, that fits your style better. Okay, there you go. I hope it helps. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one.